We're back on the West Coast for Wednesday Night Volleyball on ESPNU from Los Angeles in the campus of USC. Sophomore outside hitter Samantha Bricio leads the number four Trojans up against Kelly Reeves and the 11th-ranked UCLA Bruins as Pac-12 conference play gets underway tonight. And one of the best conferences in the country, the Pac-12, features two of its finest tonight to open up conference play. Number 11 USC, number 11 UCLA, and number 4 USC at the Galen Center. 13-mile trip across the town for UCLA. They're 21-20 all-time at USC. But these two teams have been very tight as of late. They've split their last 10 matches overall. One of those UCLA wins came in 2011 here at the Galen Center, and that's a rarity because USC is 96-10 all time in this building. And with a guy who knows a little bit about this rivalry, with Karch Kiraly, Adam Amin on hand, these are two teams that have one loss on their seasons. Both of those losses have come to a top 10 team, and both of these two teams were very good offensively a year ago, but they're transitioning each into a 6-2.
They sure are. And what that means is you're playing with two setters instead of one. There's an advantage. You have lots of hitters at the net. The disadvantage is you're trying to run an offense with two half quarterbacks. Sometimes the timing can get off. USC might have a little advantage because their offense is simpler, a little slower, lower risk, and they can handle that.
Yeah, UCLA is trying to find a little offense, and as we dive into our impact players, they rely heavily on the outside pin.
They sure do. They've got both these teams have 1-3 punches. Kelly Reeves covers a ton of court, receives the other team, serve very well, and when she does that, they can get the ball to their favorite offensive target, Karch DeLow. Lots of kills for them when she's on the court. On the other side, Natalie Haglund, also a great receiver of serve. And Samantha Bricio, also a big arm, but she stays on the court the whole time. And that's where USC has another advantage, having her arm in the front court and the back.
You see the rules, nothing has changed. These substitutions, bottom line, that changed a year ago. They went from 12 to 15. That'll help these two teams much more this year than it did last because they're both using more subs with that 6-2 offense. UCLA starts with service. And according to USC, this is the 100th meeting all time. According to UCLA, it's the 114th. UCLA on the board first tonight, and it's Karch DeLow.
And that's what they want to do, get the ball a lot to Karch DeLow when she's in the front row for that half of the game. When she rotates to the back, she'll be off.
Jordan Robbins, a freshman center in the 6-2. They're missing one of their normal centers from last year in Megan Moynoa. She's dealing with an injury, so she's out. And right away, UCLA, after the side out, has to deal with one of the best servers in the country, one of the heaviest balls in the nation. That's Bricio. Already 26 aces.
She left too early.
Right away, UCLA out of system with Bricio on the back line, and it leads to a kill.
And that does not count as an ace in the stats. It doesn't show up anywhere, but it created a very easy point scoring opportunity. One of the tough things about this serve is it has some spin, but not a lot. We call it a hybrid. It's not a knuckleball, and it's not a true topspin serve, and it's really tough to track. In fact, UCLA spent a ton of time in warmups, in the pregame activities, having their coaches serve that very hybrid serve at them.
Bricio elevates so high here. And notice on the serve, she doesn't flip it and put a bunch of spin on it. It's a flat toss, and then she tries to put some spin on it. That's big for UCLA, getting Bricio off the service line. Mick Haley wants her there as often as possible. 10-year anniversary of that second national title for Mick Haley this year.
Two swings, two kills already for Lowe.
This is Kelly Reeves. Schreier's got a pair of kills in the opening 5 points tonight. Hannah Schreier, the junior middle blocker, got the starting spot in the M2 position during the springtime. There's been a little bit of a revolving door in the middles for USC.
In fact, Coach Haley says, I like it. I don't even know if I have the right players on the court
yet
because there's so much competition for some of these positions.
Good serve by Haglund. Reeves got it up. And there's the first USC block of the night. Kleinman is denied. That big front line with Olgaard and Wanebu.
Again, not an ace, but that put Reeves in a ton of trouble, allowing USC to set up a great block for the easy point.
And Haglin, one of the great liberos in the country, arguably the best.
There's a better pass.
And Kleinman puts it away. Haglin was stepping up to try to cover the middle there.
Well, you caught her. She shouldn't have been stepping up. She should have been much more still and balanced rather than falling forward on that. And then she makes an easier play.
Haglin's counterpart, Carly Drolson, has started the last few matches at libero for UCLA. That's been a position of question for the Bruins. One able to kill.
And one reason UCLA is doing that, serving Bricio short, is when they pull her in, now she can't really get set out of the back row. It becomes a little easier to block this very strong offensive team by blocking three hitters instead of four, taking her out of the play.
Michael Seeley, the head coach of UCLA, looks on, replaced the great Andy Banikowski. Won a title in his second year at UCLA. That was in 2011. Speaking of freshman centers in the 6-2, Ali Pizzasegola for USC, and Carstolo already has three terminations for the Bruins.
And here's where UCLA, you would think that when she's in the front court, they're probably going to gain a little, maybe add to their lead or reduce a deficit. But now she goes out for the other half of the game, and this is critical for USC. Can they not bleed points and give up any more on their deficit?
Mark it down, 5-4 USC when Lowe goes out. Bricio, three-point pass. Shaw pulls the block. Sarah Shaw has been very much a focal point of the offense since the midway point of last year. Has improved mightily on the pin position, and now she's back to serve the senior from Texas.
And she's been doing a really nice job of controlling the ball for them for much of her career. Coach Haley says she needs to get a little of her confidence back in that skill, which has been so strong for her. For several years.
Sorry, Karch. Nice job by Drolson there on the pass, and it leads to an Aquino kick.
And this is what Coach Seeley was talking about. We want to get our middles the ball, and that's hitting a space between blockers, a very effective play, running it at the gap.
Good pass, Bricio. Nice job on the dig by Monica Stauber. She's the setter now out of the back row. And Reeves, not a lot on it, but she uses the block.
And the reason she didn't have a lot on it is she didn't get off the net there. Really a lucky point by UCLA, but nice defense over here by Monica Stauber.
Haglin, good pass. Here's Bricio. One-on-one, and Stauber gets the dig. Set her out of the play. Free ball, UCLA. Good play. Bricio high. Oh, pretty play by Bricio coming back, and USC back in front.
USC likes to run her inside off the sideline. So watch, she's going to come in to the C there on the court and then drop it over her shoulder. She can also often hit it very sharp cross court. UCLA has to look for both those shots.
No Haglin on this rotation with Olgaard serving. Drolson tight to the net. Good save, Stauber. Not a great touch by Bricio, and trying to save it was Emily Young. It's out to UCLA.
You're exactly right. Bricio needs to make the first contact and not worry about, she was thinking so much about attacking that she didn't keep the ball on her side of the net far enough.
Here's the Brazil native, Mariana Aquino. Good float to Bricio. Puts a lot of heat on that ball. This is what we talk about behind the service line at the net. A lot of heavy action on her attacks.
Lots of coaches call it a big arm or a heavy arm. And when she hits it off that block, it goes high and deep like that. And if you're not well positioned and balanced, it's a very difficult shot to track down. Watch UCLA still just passing with two. Reeves, a perfect pass. And that starts the offense. She's the starter. And then she hopes to have a lot of finishers. And here comes Carstolo. So they didn't lose any ground that time.
They
gained one.
That's right. They win that battle 4-3 with Carstolo off. And this is Jordan Robbins on serve. She's setting now in the 6-2 out of the back row. Not a good pass by Shaw. Pushed by Wanebu.
And not a great shot by Lowe either, to give essentially a free ball to the other team. Much better to keep that on your own side, run your offense, and then she can take the third swing, the third hit contact with her swing.
UCLA in front for the first time since they scored the opening point.
Ooh, a
That's two service errors now on UCLA.
And as a coach, you have to think, wow, we have Parstolo in the game.
That's right.
We want to get the ball in, get USC in trouble, and maybe we'll have a chance to score more points, because really we're only playing half of this match with her on the floor.
18 points through, full rotation through. This is the sixth tie of the set.
And the annotation, Coach Haley was screaming for that every time. What happens is the setter, number three, Jordan Robbins, has to stay behind the person right next to her, Kelly Reeves, until this service is contacted. But she's feeling pressured to leave early because this serve is coming so hard.
Yeah, she released early on that
and
one.
She did it again.
That time she didn't
but
get
she
called.
She didn't get
for
called,
it.
Exactly.
Nightingale comes away with the kill. That was close. I'm not saying that she released early and was out of position, but she's cutting it close.
Yeah, what happens is she can't have her foot in front of Kelly Reeves until the serve is contacted.
Called the slide for Schreier, dug up by Reeves. Kleinman.
And you could hear assistant coach on the sideline there, Stein Metzger, saying, slide coming your way, Maddie. She positioned herself well, got a nice touch on the block, and then transition off for the swing.
Pass by Shaw, setting it up for Schreier. Reeves is there with the dig. And they go back to low, pushed it a little bit wide. We have been tied eight times in the opening 22 points.
And you can see that set went a little close. Low felt like she had to navigate around the block and missed it quite wide. Nice pass.
Reeves. To Nightingale with a good set that time from the freshman Robbins.
Yeah, Nightingale's moving the ball around well. She normally doesn't hit that way. We call that crossbody, hitting it to your left. Normally she hits it a little more straight, but UCLA's been working on that part of her game, trying to add a little range to her attack. It's paying off for them so far.
Shaw muscling it through the block.
Shaw!
This is the product of the 6-2. Pizza Cigola back to serve. You saw Emily Young, number 20 for USC, check back into the front row. Wanebu is off the floor, as is Haley Crone. UCLA back in front.
UCLA does the same thing. Here come two players. Setter comes on, an opposite comes on. Parstolo steps off, along with number three, Jordan Robbins.
So it was 8-8 when she came back on the floor, and they actually win with her on the floor. Now let's see if they can at least maintain with her off the floor. It's Stauber now to set and serve. A short serve. There's the lefty, Young. Claire Felix got the block, got the tip. It was pancaked up by Haglund. Good play defensively. In transition, UCLA, it's Felix. Haglund, another touch, but that'll hit the deck. And UCLA is up by two. Largest lead of this opening set.
Well, Haglund got caught a little deep here, so she had to come flying out from outside your screen. Good play. Then I thought she was going to make the next one, too. UCLA going to the same play twice.
Haglund steps up for the pass. Olgaard comes up with two.
Olgaard also hitting with more range. That's something that they've been working on with her, to be able to hit back to your left or sharp to your right, wrist away. And she's a handful there, especially when UCLA can only get one block in front of her.
Yeah, Olgaard hitting over 400 this year. And there is an ace for USC. And Sarah Shaw, we said it, she's improved in a lot of different aspects of this game.
And she is serving at mostly two passers again, with Drolson and with Reeves trying to cover the whole court. This time it's Reeves. Good pass.
They go back to that slide, and that's been working. Not really slide, I should say. They go back to the back pin. Felix comes away with another kill, and UCLA hits the 15-point mark first. This is one of the best rivalries in sports, especially in volleyball.
To the middle! A two-decade drought is done, and the Bruins are back on top.
when you're out on the court with UCLA, you know it's going to always be a fight. It's a good thing to win that game. It is a lot of bragging rights.
13 miles separate the campuses of the Bruins and Trojans, both with their sights set on not only winning this matchup, but meeting again in December.
Nice easy trip down Hollywood Boulevard. And as tight as you can be through 29 points, UCLA up by one. We've been tied 10 times in this opening set. You look at the program comparison. Look at the all-time wins. Look how close they are. Just separated by four. Two of the best programs in the country in this sport. UCLA on service. They've led by as many as two. USC has led by as many as two in this set. Young. Almost hit that on the way down from her jump, but got a nice angle on it to tie it up at 15.
With that set getting left a little inside, it helps that she's a left-handed hitter. Right. Her inside shoulder can reach and hit that inside the block. No cross court.
No haggling on the floor for USC, so Olgaard serves. Backside pin. They've been leaning on Felix a little bit in this set. That time pushed it. And USC back on top. Good read by Reeves on the sideline.
And Lowe coming back on for UCLA.
USC with a one-point lead.
I like what USC's doing. That's called isolating. They can get one hitter against one blocker, and they've been successful with both their middles in that attack. When they get a good pass.
Reeves, again, she's only about 6 feet tall. Doesn't have the most size, but she can get up there. And again, like you said, with Lowe coming back on the floor, UCLA is not losing ground with Karch Kiraly off the floor. We're tied.
That's big for them. And it's also big that they run it a little faster to somebody like Reeves, and she can, with that speed, hit the late arriving blocker.
Freshman in the 6'2", setting and serving, it's Jordan Robbins. Prone to Bricio. Reeves again. Played up. Bricio had to put it over. Prone, the setter, is out of the play. So Haglund to Wanebu. USC takes the lead.
And that's not a great matchup for UCLA. Wanebu against Reeves at the net. If USC can run its offense that way, they'd like to do that a whole lot.
Number seven on the back pin against the 6 foot Reeves. That's the matchup to watch out for. And Bricio is back to serve again. Nice pass, Drolson. Reeves on the backside puts it away. And UCLA again gets Bricio off the service line in one, thanks to Reeves. And Drolson with a good pass.
It's big for the Bruins to be able to control that serve. She can score points in bunches, but so far has been unable.
14 ties in the opening set in the Pac-12 opener. Back row, Bricio. Line drive to Kleiman, dug by Haglund. Wanebu off the net. UCLA in transition. The push to low. Stuffed by Shaw.
And that set just went too close to the net. Yeah. We were watching some of that in warm-ups. If you give a little space to a hitter like Karch Kiraly, she can work with it. But that was about 6 inches away from the blocker's hands.
Two-time Pac-12 libero of the year, Haglund. Three-point pass, Reeves. Here's Lowe. Free ball, USC. Push to Kleiman off the antenna.
Back to a two-point advantage for USC. And a timeout used by Michael Seely and UCLA. First timeout on either side. And again, this match is the largest lead on either side that we've seen in a very competitive opening set here in Los Angeles. Last season, Karch, you were here for it. Number one versus number two right here in the Galen Center. It was a good one.
It sure was.
Four sets. Ranked number one and number two in the nation, USC. USC trying to remain undefeated. Number two in the nation wins it in four. USC has beaten the top-ranked team in the country.
And in fact, the teams split four-game wins.
That's right.
On their home courts last year in Pac-12 play.
The USC actually won that match to go to 13-0. They would lose their next match after that, but that was off to a great start. USC on their way to the regional finals where they lost to Texas.
And it was a big night because you had number three against number four that same night with Penn State in the action also.
Well, another edition of College Football Primetime coming your way this Friday night. Middle Tennessee and BYU. Taysom Hill has been in the news a little bit. The quarterback for BYU, he's had a lot of struggles in his sophomore year, but no chance for benching him, Bronco Mendenhall says. You also get to see Kyle Van Noy, one of the best NFL prospects. It's Middle Tennessee and BYU Friday night. College Football Primetime on ESPNU. And watch ESPN. Great crowd on hand tonight here in Los Angeles for this crosstown showdown to open up Pac-12 play.
I sure like what Coach Michael Seely did in the timeout, calming down his setter, Jordan Robbins, after she set one too close and one too wide. Let's see how this one is.
Off the net that time to low.
Always better off than on, because low could work with that one, and she notches the easy kill.
Lowe has one more service rotation and one more receiving rotation in the front row. Drolson, the libero on service for UCLA. Somebody's got to get it. It was Shaw. Bruins in transition. Bruins come back to tie it after they trailed by two. It's tie number 15 of the opening frame. Robbins doing well in the front row, or in the setting position, I should say, finding her hitters in the front row. Olgaard, big hit. USC takes the lead back.
USC continues to use and exploit that one-on-one matchup, Olgaard, with the advantage physically there. Taller, jumping high, and she's hitting sharp back toward her left. That's something that the UCLA blockers, starting with Aquino, probably want to make an adjustment for.
Let's see if UCLA goes to low. Low has the size advantage on the pin here. Yep. Got the kill, too. Tied at 21. Low with a clutch kill, and now she comes off the floor.
And this is her favorite set. That left hand close to the setter. Coming behind, that's a blind set for the setter, but an easy one because it only has to travel about 8-10 feet in the air.
So tied at 21, Carstolo off the floor. Monica Stauber setting, the junior out of the back row. It's Young into the tape. They're going to say that it's a point for USC. There may have been a touch, and it looks like there was.
That's a good call. That touched the block.
Yep.
One of the risks UCLA has is if this game doesn't last much longer, they'll have Lowe off the court at that critical juncture, the end of the game.
Shot to the net, won by Young. Still alive for Felix. Now the Trojans in transition, and Olgaard puts it down the corner. Michael Seely uses his second timeout. This was back a couple of points, the play on the net we were talking about.
That ball definitely hit the left hand of the blocker there. Good call by the referees. And then nice transition work by Olgaard to get off the net, get some space. And that time, she'd been hitting the other part of the court. That time she hit it to her right.
really been tough to stop so far for UCLA.
USC 2 points away from taking the opening set. You see what these two teams have done when they take the opening set, both undefeated so far. Again, their lone losses have come to top 10 teams. Hawaii was the team to beat UCLA. Meanwhile, San Diego, upstart Toreros, although they return a ton, five seniors on that team, knocked off USC. San Diego turns around, and BYU comes back and sweeps the Toreros. The parity this season in the early part of this campaign has been a lot of fun to watch.
And the one thing that San Diego did really nicely was make Samantha Bricio do a lot of the work. They served Hatter, they made her carry a very heavy load, and they were able to bog down USC's offense as a result.
We've had a handful of number ones already. USC's been number one. Texas was the preseason number one. They lost a match to Arizona State. Penn State's back at the number one spot, but they have a loss this year. Washington in action tonight against Washington State. Stanford's playing Cal. Arizona's playing Arizona State, which is ranked. It's a lot of fun in the Pac-12 and all over the country. And USC 2 points away from a first set win. Here's Bricio.
Nice.
What a dig by Reeves. Kleinman blocked. Drolson there. Joust at the net. It's put over to USC, and Haglund saved it. Here's Bricio. Another dig by Reeves. Kleinman on the outside.
And that's a nice adjustment. The third swing of the rally by Maddie Kleinman. USC is giving her a little bit of line, so good choice to turn it away from the defense of USC.
And here is Maddie Kleinman, the sophomore. Young. Still set point USC.
Started with a great pass by Reeves, right on the money, and a wonderful set by Stauber, isolating her hitter one-on-one. Second set point for USC.
Aquino to serve. Bricio to put it away. Dug up by Kleinman. Reeves on the outside. It's out of bounds, and the Trojans take the first set. You can see it. Reeves did not like the call, but the first set to the Trojans, we had 16 ties in the opening frame. What more did you expect from two of the greatest programs in women's volleyball? Short trip down to the Santa Monica Pier from where we're at in Los Angeles. 25-23, USC takes the opening set in the Pac-12 opener against UCLA. Back with Karch Kiraly, Adam Amin. Again, neither team led by more than two. We had 16 ties in the first set. What did you see?
USC had great success in the middle. Olgaard going off and Schreyer going off. That's where UCLA is going to have to serve tougher to get USC out of its offense. They contained Bricio.
That's right.
They did their job. Karsten Lowe did a nice job, too. The other problem UCLA had was a couple of wayward sets in their two-setter offense. One too tight, one outside. Both those got hit out, and there's your two-point difference.
Exactly. It was that tight in the opening set. You see it, two aces, a couple of service errors on both sides. You could say there's a difference, the two blocks, the two aces for USC on the back line as well. Speaking of aces, UCLA actually did a nice job against Samantha Bricio getting her off the service line, but why is it so important to get her off the service line?
Because she is so tough to stop. She can hit that thing really hard. First of all, she gets a lot of elevation, so some servers don't use all the jump they have. Secondly, she gets some nice rotation. You can see her shoulders coming around, just like a pitcher in baseball. She can generate more power,
And it's not a true top spin. It's got some side spin to it, some hybrid, some nasty. And it, you really have to track it all the way until it hits your arms.
And it will be Bricio to open up the second set.
And they often like to start with their best server, the server who scores them the most points. That's Bricio. Now they create a scoring opportunity. That's out of system. And, oh, big mistake by Bricio.
Nice shot by Nightingale to put it away.
What an easy play. You never want to put it right back over the net to the opponents. Much better to keep it way off the net for your setter. In this case, that would have been Haley Krohn who could have touched the ball.
And again, one serve, she's off the line. Wanebu ended up playing that one. And a free ball to UCLA. It turned into a tough one, but Drolson got it up. And it turns into a kill for Lowe. USC in the net anyway. Let's keep that tracking once again when Lowe is on the floor.
And you can see Lowe laughing. She got horrible contact on this. Watch if we can see her swing. Yeah, UCLA was really scrambling. But when she swings there, there's no spin on the ball. It had a knuckleball. She was laughing at herself, but sometimes those are the best ones.
She's kind of punched at it, basically. Hey, nice shot by Robbins to get that ball up initially. Drolson makes it a tough free ball. A lot of power behind that one from Shaw to get the Trojans on the board.
That's a nice set for Shaw. Looks like the right height, the right tempo for her, and 4 feet off the net, she can swing freely against the UCLA block.
Here is Haglin. Not a great set. It was a little low for Karstalone, but just a quick punch over, just pushed it down and got the kill.
It's interesting. Both these coaches talked about UCLA having lots of injuries, playing with lots of different players. Sealy talking about them kind of being the land of the misfits. And Coach Haley with USC saying, you know, I don't know if I have all of my players even close to in the right rotation, so they're still trying to figure things out. But considering that, the level of play is pretty good.
Now USC returns just about everybody. Katie Fuller really the big loss, but UCLA has so much to replace. Rachel Kidder's gone. Tabby Love is gone. They lose their libero in Todorovich. This is the sophomore Drolson taking that spot. And they're both transitioning into a 6-2. So there's a lot to work out for both of these head coaches. And this is what UCLA loses, nearly 8.5 kills a set from last year.
Two big arms out on the left side that they don't have. And in fact, Kelly Reeves is one of the players who has stepped into that role. She didn't play that role the last couple of years, played more on the right side and utility and did lots of things for this UCLA team.
It's Pizza Segola on serve.
Ooh.
Tight to the net, and that was an easy push down by Olgaard and Young, and USC is back within one.
A great illustration why you don't want to push your own hitter too close to the net, especially against this physical block of somebody like Alexis Olgaard standing at 6'5".
Just missed Pizza Segola there. And this is a USC team that has improved its block from a season ago. Their offensive numbers are a little bit down. Natalie Haglin's digs are a little bit down, but they're getting more points generated from the block than they did last year, and the opponent's hitting percentage is actually lower than it was last season. Young gets stuffed. It's Claire Felix with the block, the freshman out of Colorado Springs.
And now you've got a 6'6" over there. That's not a great matchup for USC. UCLA would like more sets to go her way.
First block of the night for the Bruins. Olgaard got it down.
That's the better matchup for USC. 6'5" against Aquino in the middle at 6'2" or 6'3".
Sarah Shaw, the senior. That's what you're talking about. Aquino, and didn't get a whole lot on that either, but Olgaard too easy for that block.
USC doing a really nice job of seeing what the setter was doing and reading, getting two blockers up on that quick attack.
A couple of good passes by Drolson back to back, and it leads to a big kill for Claire Felix.
Nearly 50 kills this season for Claire Felix coming into this match. And size is not something that UCLA is missing on its roster, but they need some size in the pins, and Felix gives it to them. Bricio and Olgaard out of the middle turns it into a kill from Pizzasico.
And you can see on that play, UCLA is trying to get more blockers up on her because she's been so effective. So Kelly Reeves was trying to be a blocker. It was more like 1.5 against Olgaard, still not enough to slow her down.
Here's Alexis on the serve. That time not a great pass from Jolson.
Wow.
Well, Young's eyes got big, and that one nearly sailed on her, but she clipped the back line, and we're tied at 7.
A couple of very poor, for this good ball control team, a couple of very poor sets by UCLA in this second set. One completely over, one way too close to the net.
Jolson steps up that time again. Not a good set to Reeves. Pizza Segola, back row attack. This 5'10", a little tougher for her to save those difficult passes.
Yeah, it's not really her fault. Olgaard's
right, so it's not a great
way,
pass.
Way on her side of the net. Again, both teams trying to play the ball too close. That's a nice serve.
Aquino with a beautiful serve, and it's down for an ace, and it's 9-7 UCLA.
What happens is sometimes when people try to serve short, it goes really high, but you see how low and flat that trajectory was. Gives passers a lot less time to react and make a play.
Aquino led the Bruins in aces last year. That was just the fifth of her season this year. Bricio, a lot of power. Reeves couldn't hit it.
Bricio!
I don't know what middle blocker number 13, Zoe Nightingale, was thinking. She was running away from Bricio. And then the set goes the other right to Bricio.
Haley Krohn checks in, setting and serving, back row. Trojans in transition, they want one able, and when able wants the floor, she can get down on time.
That's a nice matchup there.
Again, we talked about it before, when Reeves is on the pin, and they've got somebody like Wanabu at 6'4", 6'5", they've got to go there.
That's what one big job for setters is. You got to look at the matchup.
The low shot, Reeves is there. USC has its first lead of the second set. They've scored 3 in a row. They've scored 5 of the last 7 to jump out in front.
Remember, this is all with Karstalo.
That's right.
Off the court. Her position is in the back row right now.
That's a clutch kill from Reeves. We saw it in the first set. Lowe was off the floor for the final, 4 or 5 points. Not saying that that directly led to UCLA losing, but it certainly didn't help with her off the floor. Now, Karstalo is back on the floor. She's in the front row with Reeves and Nightingale, so a little more size up front as well for UCLA. And that's something that Jordan Robbins cannot afford, a second service error for her, and USC takes the lead again.
Might even be 3. I remember 2 in
the first
set.
I think you're right.
And those are 3 lost opportunities for that block of low out on UCLA's right side.
Yeah, Karch, you got it right. All 3 service errors to the freshman Jordan Robbins playing in this matchup for the first time. And that time it was Bricio's own fault, but UCLA is getting Bricio off the service line after one serve.
They've got to be very happy in keeping her scoring to a minimum.
Fourth tie, the first 22 points in set 2. We had 16 ties in a USC victory in the opening frame by 2 points. Nice shot. The 2 of the block by Schreier. Natalie Hagelin says she's in the best shape of her career. 2-time Pac-12 libero of the year. Karstalo is stuck by Olgaard. First big, really big block we've seen from USC.
And if you have a choice between hitting at number 10 Shaw and number 1 Olgaard, you probably want to challenge the smaller outside blocker, not the intimidating presence in the middle.
go back to low, a low set once again, but she got a touch on the outside against the smaller Shaw, and it turns into a side out for the Bruins. Bojana Todorovic is gone. Averaged 4 digs a set last year.
Maddie!
Starting libero graduated. Good short serve, and it leads to the Bruins in transition. And that one was down on two by Robin. She's setting out of the back row, but if you jump and don't break the top plane of the net, you can still send it over.
Yeah, if there's some part of the ball that is below the top of the net, then that is a legal play, even if you jump.
That's a heady play by the freshman there to tie it at 13. That's the pros and cons of the short serve. It led to an easy point that time with all the height on it.
Way too much trajectory on that. And I don't know if you heard it, but number one, Alexis Olgaard screaming, one. You can tell when a hitter is ready and really wants the ball, and she did that time, winning that matchup easily.
Pizza Segola, the freshman.
Defense for a point.
And USC hits the 15-point mark first. Alexis Olgaard has been fun to watch in this second set especially. Alexis Olgaard, a lot of size up front, 6'5", the senior trying to lead the Trojans to a 2-0 lead. We talk about it. As you get a look at the Hollywood sign, USC, UCLA, phenomenal rivalry. These programs know each other well, and these players, especially in the Pac-12, know each other well. This past summer, the country of China welcomed the Pac-12 All-Stars. Mick Haley coached the Pac-12 All-Stars. Natalie Haglund and Haley Crone of USC. Haley Crone did not play, was dealing with a stress fracture at the time, missed the actual playing, but they got a chance to play with Kelly Reeves of UCLA. Kelly has been doing a lot of stuff for the UCLA website, and there's some videos of her. There she is on the Great Wall of China. I mean, these players know each other all too well. Reeves has a lot of connections with family on the other side of the net. I mean, this is a fun rivalry because of the relationships.
And a number of these players compete in various USA programs.
That's right.
And they become American teammates. So lots of shared experiences, which is great. And then they get to face each other, of course, across the net in college.
Yeah, we got a chance to see it as Karch Kiraly gets the side-out kill and steps off. So keep a note of that, 15-14 when Lowe's off the floor. We're privy to watching this outstanding rivalry. It's the 100th meeting going back to 1976 when USC became a scholarship sport. They did play each other before that. But 100th meeting as a scholarship sport. How about that rally for UCLA? Drolson comes up with a huge kill, or a huge dig, excuse me, and Kleiman comes up with the kill.
This is what's called transitioning, coming up with a play. A great dig by Drolson there, and then Kleiman again finding that line like she did late in the second, in the first set. USC leaving her a little bit of space there.
Felix regretting that she played that one up. Trojans get a transition chance. It's a sloppy one, though. Trojans reset. It's Bricio out of the back row and dug up by Reeves. Fincher did not touch it, according to the officials. After she attacked, she did not touch it off the block. The Trojans are claiming she did.
I thought it hit the floor first, but let's see if we can get a look here.
I think you're right. I think it hit the floor and then her leg.
Yeah, it looked like it hit floor, then shin. But Coach Haley not happy about that.
Well, since the media timeout, UCLA with 3 consecutive points. Pizza Segola to Olgaard. Nice set right at the top, right at the apex of that Olgaard jump.
You could hear her again. 1-1 calling it. Setters rely on that kind of intonation. And a hungry call from hitters. They'll give it to the person who's almost like trying to talk them into setting their way.
Drolson got handcuffed. It's an ace for Shaw. And a USC lead.
USC going at the libero, who most of the time is the strongest passer. See if they go at her again.
They do.
And they get her in trouble again.
And Trollson's been hit or miss. Some really great passes and some rough ones as well. This time it turns into a kill for Young, and it's a two-point USC lead. They answer with three consecutive points.
And that can be difficult if your libero, who is your best passer, starts getting in some trouble. Can get into the heads of some of the other passers. I would have gone back at her instead of going to Reeves there.
Good coverage by Reeves. Jost at the net. That is still a legal play. Aquino played it. And here's Bricio. Kleinman dug by Haglin. Smart play by Kleinman to put it down. Looking at the lead official, no net call that time on UCLA, so it is a Bruin point.
Haglin had it all lined up, just didn't have the right angle with their arms, put it back over the net.
A nice flat serve, good save, Bricio.
That'll take her out of the offense.
She comes all the way to the net, and she's no longer an option when she's that close to her setter and beats a Segola. UCLA comes back to tie it with two straight points, so all of a sudden a set of runs, and McHaley will take a timeout. So how about this? UCLA down 15-14 right now when Carstolo comes off the floor. And again, they're not losing ground right now. That's a great point you made right at the top, and she's having a good match when she is on the floor.
They're controlling the serve of Bricio, and they're not losing a lot of ground when they're off. The thing that they've been having trouble with is stopping Alexis Olgaard in the middle attack of USC.
Gonna look at Carstolo. Fewer than 500 attacks total in her first 2 years. She's a junior now, and she is gonna go over 300 in this match. She had about 280 coming into this match. So this is a huge year for Carstolo, feature role, especially with what the Bruins lost on the pins last year.
They look to her to carry a huge load, and she does that especially considering that she is only on the court half the time. So that's where so much of their offense comes from.
See her line so far, 9 kills and hitting over 460. And despite all the attacks that she's getting, she's hitting nearly 400 on the season. It's been an impressive year. Well, it's maybe a little too early to start talking Heisman, but Taj Boyd at number 3 Clemson will take on Wake Forest. Taj is going to try to keep his push to the Heisman going. That's at 3:30 on ESPNU. Then Florida, a chance to go to 2-0 in the SEC East. They'll have a chance to be the lone team with a 2-0 lead. Georgia's got a tough matchup with LSU coming up this weekend as well. That's our doubleheader. You'll see the ACC and the SEC, both games live on Watch ESPN as well.
Possible to get more of those than just
good offense from USC right out of the timeout. Good pass, Haglin and Olgaard with her 9th kill of the match.
She has been unstoppable.
So now she's in the back row. She'll serve here. The libero Haglin comes off for the rotation. Reeves. Bricio. I'm going to say it's a cut for USC off the hands of the Bruins first, then into the antenna. And USC has a 2-point lead. And Michael Seely will use a timeout here.
Coach Haley talks about Bricio and how much she's matured since last season. You know, probably struggling with English a little coming from Mexico, but she's starting to provide some leadership for her team and really enjoying it, thinking about staying here full time, even in the summers, with USC, as many college volleyball players do.
Again, she's only 18 years old. She's not going to turn 19 until November. And this was Sam Bricio playing at the Pan American Games, and Mick Haley told us that he's kind of scared about seeing Bricio in international competition because you know everybody's going to want her for their professional teams. And like you said, she's thinking about actually staying full-time at USC. She's a sophomore now.
The other thing he's a little afraid about is just he felt she came back with her confidence shaken after playing for the Mexican national team and whatever it was that the coach was, how he was communicating with her. So it took her a little while to get it back to start this season.
And led the Pac-12 in aces last year. So having a great season behind the service line again this year. The freshman of the year a year ago in the Pac-12. became the top attacker for USC as a freshman. Alex Jupiter, all the offense that they lost. Alex Jupiter is the all-time USC kills leader, by the way. So think about the pressure that a 17-year-old steps into when she first gets to the United States to play volleyball. It's incredible. They have come out in droves tonight for this one. The rowdy crowd, good match so far, and a substitution here, a service substitution for USC.
They scored a couple with Olgaard, so they want to upgrade the defensive part of that equation.
This is Taylor Whittingham, a walk-on defensive specialist, playing in her 19th set of the season. And a good serve. That was to Inoue, who's in the match for UCLA, a fresh passer as well. Young blocked. Bricio, Doug, quick touch over by Stauber. Big rally here. This is Young, off the tape, dug up by Felix. Bricio on the outside, dug by Reeves. Felix got the kill. Big side out for UCLA. Shaw couldn't handle it on the back line. Back and forth we've gone in this match all night. It's Aquino. That time, good pass Shaw. Young. It's stuffed! What a block by Nightingale, and we're tied for the 33rd time tonight.
Nightingale with a great move to her left. And watch her shoot her hands across. That's what you want to do as a blocker, reach across the net, not high above the net.
Hurry, Sammy, hurry. Here's Bricio. Aquino with the dig. It's a push to Sam again on the outside. That's pancaked up by Reeves. Trojans in transition again. Stauber out of the play. Push down. That's a point for Schreier. And USC back on top.
Nightingale was working really hard to try to get another block. She did what we call commit. Just jumped as hard as she could to try to stop Stauber. Stauber still works the ball around her.
Now it's Krohn setting and serving.
Ooh.
And Stauber, quick tap over. One able, it's blocked! Kelly Reeves at 6 feet tall, blocking the 6'4 freshman.
Stauber getting a break there. She gave USC an easy one. A free ball. USC gets that nice swing, but Reeves with a good left hand on that.
One able, wrestling it through the block. She breaks the 26th tie. We said 33 earlier. 26 ties in the first set, nearly two sets in this match. Continuing to go back and forth. And here we go. Bricio with her team up by one, 3 points away to serve. And they go after Drolson. She comes up with the pass. And that was off target from Karstall Lowe. Pushed towards the pin.
Pushed far too wide on that play. The things you don't want to do are set wide and set too close to the net. And UCLA has been having some trouble. That was probably the difference in set number one. Maybe again here with USC up by 2 points.
Diving dig by Haglin. One Abu off the net. Who's going to play it? Haglin from her backside played it up. Krohn, the setter, is out of the play. Here's one Abu. Set points for USC to work with, their largest lead of the match, and Haglin coming up big.
She was ready to make this play. before it was touched. First, she makes that wonderful move forward, but later in the rally, she's ready to make this play right here. She's going to make that, and then the blocker touches it. So I'll just set it while I'm sitting on the floor, keep it alive, and then Wanebu with a huge swing coming up off of the set of Haglin. Cross court, hard. That's a big arm. Kelly Reeves can't control it.
Natalie Haglin continues year in and year out to impress. All the things that, you know, people hype about her. I mean, when you see them on the court, her ball control, the spectacular plays stick out, yes, and they're very exciting and very impressive, but it's the ball control that she constantly displays that's maybe the most impressive thing.
And we've seen those are the big parts of any Libro's job. She does them well. She receives the serve of the other team well. She plays defense, and she does the setting when the setter contacts the first play.
26 ties in the match, 8 lead changes as well. It has been back and forth, and UCLA has had opportunities, but it's USC on the verge of taking a 2-0 lead in the conference opener and this rivalry matchup. And it's still Bricio to serve for USC. They went after Inoue, who again checked in as a passer. Now she's going to come out for UCLA. She came up with a couple of big touches on her time on the floor. Still set point USC. Net violation against Carstolo. And it's 2-0 Trojans here at the Galen Center. Two tight sets from start to finish, and they both belong to the Trojans. They've got the 2-0 lead. When we come back, we're going to dive into the mind of Karch Kiraly, the 4-time All-American, the national champion, the Olympic medalist. Talk about what makes a good setter. Solgaard has been a major piece to the puzzle for USC. She's a big reason why. They've got a 2-0 lead. 9 kills without an error. She's got 4 blocks in the match. It's been very entertaining between the first set and the second set. A bunch of ties, a lot of lead changes back and forth, as we kind of expected. Back with Karch Kiraly, Adam Amin. These are two teams that are still transitioning offensively into a 6-2. Maybe not the, I guess, high-profile setters that some of the 5-1 teams around the country have. So let's kind of transition into the 5-1 for you as the head coach of the women's national team. You look a lot at setters. What makes a good one to you?
Well, certainly it's a lot like a quarterback. You got to start and be able to locate the ball. You've got lots of parts to your job. But right here, you've got 4 hitters in your offense. Who can you get the ball to? And you got to get it in a good spot, just like having 4 receivers running patterns down the field. Again, have to put it in the right spot for any one of those hitters. Then you've got to be able to run the tempo. Now, with Texas, it's pretty easy. Just set it up there and let somebody like Haley Eckerman go get after it. Ba-boom. But lots of other teams can't rely on such a high tempo, and they run something fast, like Oregon with Lauren Plum. And there's a space between those blockers, and that you could take advantage of that with that speed. You also have to be decisive. See where the block goes. Oh, the middle blocker leaves. Well, set the quick. There's a huge space there. Another chance. Penn State leaving a huge area of court open against Oregon. Find the space one-on-one. Those are good decisions. Then you just have to be able to elevate the play of those around you. This isn't a great pass, but can I get it close, but not too close to the net for a kill? If a setter can do that, she can make her team a lot better and her hitters a lot better. Another poor pass here, making it into a nice swing and a kill for Penn State. Finally, you got to provide a lot of leadership. You got to look people in the eye. You got to be able to have the right body language, even when things are going really lousy for your team. And you put that all together, it makes for a great setter.
And these are some of the top setters in the country. Misha Hancock, Molly Kreklo, Lauren Plum, all were featured in there. I mean, think about what Molly Kreklo's done. Missouri's the most efficient offense in the country. You don't really think of Missouri maybe in that category, but right now they've got the best hitting percentage. Lauren Plum leads the nation in assist percent, and then we're talking about efficiency. Penn State right now has the third most efficient offense in the country, and all those numbers all belong to those three setters. Outstanding work by Kreklo, Plum, and Hancock, all starting to become, actually all are veterans now at this point.
And remember, some of those numbers can change. Preseason opponents are a lot different than playing Big Ten, Pac-12, and some of the other great conferences.
Well, we've been privy to a good match so far tonight, and we've got to buckle up for a pretty good one in the third set because this one's not done yet. UCLA has fought hard in this one, but it's been Bricio and Olgaard and Haglund coming up with big plays to have the Trojans on top. Teams in Los Angeles tonight of the Pac-12 season opener. Two of the best offenses in the country look like it in the opening two sets, two very tight sets, but it's the Trojans with a 2-0 lead. Back with women's national team head coach Karch Kiraly, Adam Amin. Both teams hit over 320 in the first two sets, but we saw some very impressive defense, and Alexis Olgaard has been doing it on both sides of the net so far.
She has been unstoppable. 9 kills, 0 errors out of 14 attempts, almost 650. UCLA, there are a few solutions to that problem. Number one, you got to serve tougher.
Right.
So the pass is way away and you can't get Olgaard the ball. Number two, maybe you bring more blockers in to try to slow her down. But USC has other weapons they can go to if that's the case.
And Olgaard led the way for a team that hit 352 as a club in the opening two sets. 9 kills, 4 blocks as well.
Yeah, and you could see UCLA trying to stop her with one blocker. That is not working. So there, the block, another blocker was pinching in but didn't jump. And now two blockers jump and still no success for the UCLA block.
It's the size of Olgaard that has really done it tonight. 6'5", the senior out of Spokane. She's leading the way. Wanebu has had some clutch kills. She's got 5. Karsta Lowe with 9 kills to lead it for UCLA. Did have 4 errors, though, on 15 swings. Is hitting 333. Probably like to see more swings from UCLA's top attacker. But there is Alexis Olgaard. Second in the Pac-12 last year in attack percentage, and she did get a lot of swings out of the middle. That's something that made USC very impressive offensively. She is a sharp shot, likes to actually shoot guns with her dad, Bruce. And that same accuracy has certainly played a role in her volleyball career so far.
Causing lots of trouble for UCLA with those 9 kills plus involved on 4 stuffed blocks. So she's accounted for 13 points, about a quarter of USC's total.
And USC is out blocking UCLA 6-3 so far in this match. Both offenses, though, as we said, have been very good. UCLA isn't used to this, though, being this good offensively and seeing a team better than them. UCLA has won 42 straight matches when they've hit 300 or better. So think about that. If you're hitting 300, you're going to win a match. But Michael Seeley's team is seeing a team it's at its equal offensively on the other side of the net.
And that's one of the strange things about volleyball and about coaching. You can hit 400 and lose. You can hit 100 and win. It all depends on how the rest of the parts of your game are going, like serving, ball control, blocking, defense. And USC overpowering the Bruins a little at the net.
And Nick Haley is sitting at 1,097 wins for his women's volleyball coaching career. He has nearly 1,200 if you had the stint at Kellogg Community College when he also coached the men's team. That was the job he had before Texas. Then he had a chance with the women's national team. Then he came to USC and won a couple of titles. UCLA down 2-0 in the Pac-12 opener, and off we go in the third. UCLA on the board first, Wanebu with the air. The teams with one loss, UCLA 9-1. Their loss to Hawaii, which is now 6th in the ABCA poll. The loss for USC came to San Diego, and San Diego shot to number 2 after their win over the Trojans. San Diego, since has lost a match, they dropped down to the polls. Nice shot by Schreier, tied at 1.
And UCLA started with Maddie Kleinman the first couple of games. A change there, who the defender who dug the ball back over the net, Haley Lawless, helping him out now.
Now she's back there on the passing line for this Bricio serve. She's going to go after Drolson, who was hit or miss in the first two sets. That was Lawless the dig. Carstolo dug by Haglund, but it's down to the deck, and UCLA is in front. And
there's an example of that tempo we were talking about that setter's got to be able to run. That was quite fast. Out to the left sideline for Carstolo, earned her a very easy kill because she was hitting against only one blocker.
Yeah, good timing that time. Reeves on the serve. Bricio with the pass. Schwerva's blocked. Bruins in transition. Not a good set that time from Robbins. Bricio back row. The center, Robbins, out of the play. Somebody's got to take it. And Drolson comes out of nowhere for the second touch.
That is not a good choice.
Robbins gave it up on that. UCLA had such an opportunity. They saved the point with Drolson getting that second touch. Not a good decision by the freshman that time.
No, don't give an easy one back to the opponent when they keep giving you easy ones. Right into the hands of Bricio. Easy free ball play. USC makes UCLA pay for that poor decision.
Haglund. Oh, nice shot by Nightingale. It looked ugly, but it worked. That's a great save by Lawless. Drolson, the third touch. And Olgaard with a change of pace got Robbins back on her heels. Boy, it's been sloppy, but these are really important points in the opening points of the third.
Yeah, you saw how Robbins jumped up, stood up, and that's a hard play to make defensively if you go to straight legs.
You saw the smirk on Olgaard's face. She knew she got away with one there, too. Good read by Reeves, tied at three. Five service errors for USC, three for UCLA, all on the freshman Robbins. This is the sophomore Drolson. She's made some spectacular plays tonight. She's made some poor ones as well on the passing. That's an error on the service, but that's a sophomore stepping in for a pretty good libero in Todorovic.
But you know what? If I'm a coach, I don't worry about that. You have to. UCLA has to step up its serving and attack at the line more. Otherwise, Olgaard is just going to kill you with easy pass after easy pass. USC running its perfect offensive system.
There's Pizza Segola. Carstolo is blocked. Good save by Robbins. And it turns into a block, and there's Lawless on the outside, along with Aquino, just checking into the match in this set.
UCLA getting hands across the net just in time. Lawless helping out on that block. We'll see if she can give UCLA a lift. And the thing you really hope now, if you're Coach Mike Seely, is we got to figure out a way to win this one so my team can believe that we can, if we can win one, we can win three.
That's right.
Is what he would be thinking.
Another block there. That was off of Ruddins, who is now checked into the match for USC. So another freshman between these two teams is on the floor.
And if you're USC and Coach Haley, he's thinking, we don't want to let them up for air. We want to put the pressure on and finish this in three. Because you never want to let a good team think that, hang around and think they can play with you.
Olgaard into double figures.
There is essentially a perfect pass, and that is going to allow USC to get Olgaard the ball.
They liked Felix on that back pin in the first couple sets. Nice kill. There is Ruddins, the number two high school prospect coming out this year, part of a great recruiting class for USC.
And watch, she's going to hit down the line, but for some reason, it got vacated. Either the block was supposed to take it, or Drolson was supposed to be there. But miscommunication by the UCLA defense.
Nice dig, Haglund on Lawless. Reeves digs up Bricio. Transition for the Trojans. Here's Ruddins. Try to loop it into the corner, but we have been tied at every point in the opening dozen in this third set. 32 ties in the match so far. So you saw the freshman run-ins. Here's the redshirt freshman, Lawless. Injured her right shoulder last year. Had a great high school career in Tempe, Arizona. Bricio is stopped. Felix comes up clutch. And UCLA's block is stepping up here in the third.
That set looked a little low, and wow, what a strong right hand that time by the outside blocker, Claire Felix.
Bricio right in the seam that time. Felix and Aquino didn't close, and that left enough for Bricio to tie it at seven.
And I like it. You watch some hitters when they get stuffed after swinging hard, they don't swing
That's
hard.
Right.
The next time Bricio came back even harder, just said, oh yeah, try to block this.
Felix blocked and Bricio touched it twice. So here is Aquino, senior from Brazil. Not a good pass that time from Shaw. Bricio bails her out, and once again we're tied.
You're right, and the poor pass takes the USC middle attack out of the play, but Bricio saves it. She was really the only option. UCLA knew it was going to her. Everybody knew it was going to her. She still put it to the floor.
Now it's Krohn setting and serving. Nice quick tempo that time. Nightingale got dug. And Bricio. So Nightingale comes out, tries to make the play. Her momentum took her completely away from Bricio, who is left alone.
Yeah, she's got to work harder. Watch her there. A little lazy. She gets occupied by the middle and leans to her left and then has trouble coming to her right. Easy kill for Bricio.
And Felix comes back. Good tempo that time for UCLA. They had one-on-one. Nice job by Stauber setting it up. And now Stauber will come off the floor. Karsta Lowe's back on. And they get the freshman, Jordan Robbins, back into set. Felix checks off as well for UCLA there. We've been tied at every point, 1 through 9.
Slide two.
Bricio out of the middle that time and got Nightingale's right hand.
And you can hear the UCLA coach, Sam Metzger, calling slide two. What happens is the middle attack goes behind the setter. The outside comes in. Easy kill there. In the middle of the court against the UCLA block.
And now it's Bricio. One rotation through, 10-9. Nice sliding dig, Haglin. Bricio back row. Nice dig by Jolson there. Long, and USC has the first 2-point lead on either side in this set. Neither team in this match has led by more than 3. Save it with one hand. Again, a tough pass because of Bricio's serve.
This is about as many she has scored in a row,
yep.
Shockingly.
That's
You'd
right.
expect more, but UCLA would be well served to try to shut her down right here and pass off the net, get a good swing.
They've done a nice job against her.
That's the pass you want. Off the net, you get a swing.
Haglin negates it. Wanebu on the outside. Big time elevation, and USC has its largest lead on either side in this match. Timeout Bruins. USC wanted to be more physical this year. That was a big key for that front line, and they're doing it with some freshmen up front too. Wanebu the kill to give USC its largest lead. Too long to Beverly Hills. USC up 2-0 on a 4-0 run, their largest run of the match, their largest lead of the match. This is the Pac-12 opener for these two. Arizona State beat Arizona. Utah had a match. They won the other night against Colorado. Now, number 7 Stanford, they returned so much this year. Cal's got a 1-0 lead. Oregon leading Oregon State. Washington number 2 leading Washington State. But the Pac-12 really beginning in earnest here tonight. And here USC and UCLA squaring off. Bricio on the service line for the Trojans still. Going to take over this match. And Reeves got it over the head of Bricio. And they do a nice job of finally getting Samantha off the service line. Pac-12, arguably the best conference. I think maybe it's Pac-12 Big Ten right now. They had a phenomenal preseason. 112 wins, 18 losses. An outstanding preseason for the Pac-12. Comes back side up. Now you've seen some of the teams on the West Coast, USC, UCLA. Wouldn't be shocking if we saw both these teams playing deep into December.
And those conferences prepare those teams so well, the Pac-12, the Big Ten. You just every night, and both coaches talked about it before this match, every single match is a battle. You have to fight so hard. The positive is you're really prepared for tough competition. The negative is, do you have anything left after playing a conference schedule like one of those two?
USC bounced in the regional finals. UCLA, they won the title in 2011, but they've been bounced in the second round each of the other 3 years under Michael Seale. So they're looking to improve their standing. Oregon made it to the national finals last year, but Texas a little too physical for them. Stanford returns a ton, but they got upset in the regional final last year against Michigan. So do you have enough once the end of the season rolls around?
Texas returning lots of players.
That's
also
right. What is it? I think Shadir McNeil is really the only big loss this
only
year.
One.
Come on, one dig here. One dig, Samantha.
USC up by 4. Pizza Segola, the freshman, setting and serving. Haglin digs low. Robbins, the setter, out of the play. High ball for Costello on a big kill.
That's where you see that libero has to jump in and make the set when the setter jump when the setter contacts the first one. Nicely done by Drolson on that.
Take a look at that. That's the type of match we've had all night. 35 ties. The last one was at 9-9. Since then, a 6-3 run for USC. And Olgaard got blocked that time, and a clutch block from the middle by Aquino.
And Aquino does what we call a commit. She just decides, I'm going to try and stop this. I don't care where the ball goes, but I'm jumping as hard as I can, and succeeds in finally slowing Olgaard down with her first negative play.
That's right. She did not have an error in this match until then.
And errors as a hitter are you hit out or in the net or you get blocked. And that was the first time she's been stopped.
Stauber with the service error. There's Lawless. But she's made a nice impact since coming in at the start of the third set. The redshirt freshman from Arizona gets UCLA back within 2. Half a dozen service errors now in UCLA. That's been a factor tonight in tight sets.
And again, there's a trade-off. They have to serve tougher to take USC's out of their USC out of its offense. But if you serve too tough, too many errors, too many easy points.
Pizza Segola, the setter, out of the play. Rudden's done. Oh, what a cut shot by Reeves. She was flat-footed, and she somehow found an angle to get that down.
Oh, she's played plenty of beats. She knows how to make
that's right. That's true.
So that's that wide set that you don't want to happen and really caught Bricio by surprise. That shouldn't have surprised her that much. The wider it goes, the more thin a sliver or a slice that you have to hit.
There's Bricio coming back. She was one-on-one, didn't get a great attack off. And Felix comes back with a kill, and the Bruins are back within 1. They've scored 3 of the last 4.
Come on, let's go, getting the one-on-one block and seeing that space around the outside hand of Bricio.
There's Aquino going after Bricio. Good pass. And there is Grace for the freshman from California.
I'm actually a little surprised that UCLA hasn't attacked Bricio more with its serve, because they pulled her way out of the offense, and then it really became a two-hitter attack for USC after Bricio went to the back line.
Bricio. Reeves is there. Unable. Oh, that's a big dig by Stauber, the center out of the play. Boy, Reeves looking gassed right now, but somehow she gets the kill.
And you can hear Coach McHaley talking his blockers through. Go, Hannah, go, Hannah. He wanted her to leave and just stack up on Kelly Reeves on this play. But at the end, USC chooses not to block, and there's that huge hole. Reeves finds it.
Freshman Robbins setting and serving. Bricio, good play set, good dig. Lawless, a push to Reeves. She's getting a lot of swings lately. Touched up by Lawless. Free ball coming for the Trojans. One able, cut it. And for the first time since it was 9-9, UCLA has come back to tie it. They've scored four of the last five.
And she's come up with some huge swings, but sometimes freshmen are going to swing and miss. And that was a freshman swing. Hitting the side of the ball went out of bounds.
Bricio pushed it. Nightingale put it down. And UCLA has taken the lead.
Having a little success now, changing it up and going at Bricio, causing the USC timeout.
Zoe Nightingale getting big up at the net.
And it starts with attacking Bricio a little more. She puts that too close, in fact, over the net. Easy kill. I would expect UCLA to try this new strategy of going at Bricio more and Sarah Shaw less.
Well, ESPN News coverage of college soccer continues Sunday. A women's and men's doubleheader will start in the SEC. Number 7 Florida taking on Missouri. Then at 4, more action with the men on the pitch. Florida Gulf Coast, NCAA participant a year ago. They get set to square off with Princeton. ESPN News college soccer coming up on Sunday. Both matches also available live on Watch ESPN. So it was 15-11. USC had that 4-point advantage the first time that a team had a 4-point advantage in this match. And UCLA has come back to score 8 of the last 11 and take a 19-18 lead in what has been a sparkling match to open up the Pac-12 season.
Well, this is where Coach Haley's got to be talking to them like, okay, let's just keep the ball on our side of the net. We have some really big hitters that we can swing at, or that we can set and get good swings out of. And they do not want UCLA to think that they can come back in this match.
If you're Michael Seely, what are you telling your team? Down 2-0, but a chance to get a set here.
Well, they got to keep the pressure on, I think, Samantha Bricio at the service line. Let's see if Robbins can get it to Bricio. They're having more success going at her than Shaw in the last half of this set.
Robbins has sent it deep a couple times. This time she comes up short after Shaw. And when able to an easy side out, tied at 19.
I'm a little surprised at that serve. Not only was it not at Bricio, but it was so easy. You saw the trajectory up in the air. It didn't challenge Sarah Shaw at all in her service reception motion.
And guess who? It's Bricio at 19-all. Took a little bit off that time, and Reeves is dug by Bricio. Wanebu tapped it. Bruins in transition.
Ooh.
Reeves tapped it up. Shaw played it. Hagelin was covering her from behind, but Shaw panicked a little bit. UCLA's got the lead.
Well, that's a difficult thing as a blocker. If you can reach it, but you have Haglund, who's such a good defensive player behind you, what do you do?
Right.
Every team actually tries to have a rule. And I don't know what USC's rule is, but clearly they were a little confused.
Now Reeves to serve. Schwer fading away. Got blocked back. Shaw. Haglund the touch. What a diving save. Haley Crone coming up with that second touch. Nightingale out of the middle is dug by Haglund. Crone to the outside for Shaw. And it will sail out of bounds. A hectic possession. And UCLA's got a two-point lead. Mick Haley uses a timeout here at 21-19. And the run continues. It's a 10-4 spurt here for UCLA.
UCLA getting hands in front of those USC hitters better two times in that rally. And then they get the swing. Haglund with another diving save. And right here, Shaw didn't get her feet to the ball.
Right.
Tried to make a kill out of a set that you really can't even get a kill on. So she would be wiser, because USC has good blockers too, to just keep it deep somewhere, but keep it in and let her block in defense. Win the point later.
Kelly Reeves getting a ton of swings. She's making a huge impact, as we're used to seeing for this UCLA team. They rely so heavily on Reeves and Lowe. There's number two right in the middle of that. Yashar taking a lot of breaths. Now just getting up. Reeves, her mom, Jean, an outstanding player at UCLA, was an All-American in 1982. Then came back as an assistant under Andy Banikowski for those 90 and 91 national championship teams. You can see the UCLA website. She has the Reeves report. And her mom, Jean, actually ended up playing with Elise Rudden's aunt, Kim, who's a legendary setter at USC. Her mom played Elise's aunt in the first ever national championship match in 1981. USC won, and then those two ended up being teammates on the Olympic team.
And it was interesting, too, because her mom, Jeannie, was pregnant with Kelly when they had won the championship in 91, and then they went 20 years until winning in 2011.
Incredible. USC down two. Haglund with a huge touch. Reeves gets the dig here. Here's Lowe. USC leads it by three.
UCLA doing a much better job of locating themselves on the block, creating a scoring opportunity, and Lowe terminating.
11-4 run. Bricio back row, dug up by Robbins. Nightingale on two. Crone's out of the play. One able wraps up for a side out.
So if you look at the matchup at the net,
yep,
you've got a big right side blocker in Wanegu, big in the middle in Olgaard. You have to like the matchup with your best hitter, Karsta Lowe, against the smallest blocker, Sarah Shaw. You got to expect her to set back here.
Near side. They go middle instead. They get a kill from Nightingale. Olgaard a little late. There was space for Zoe to get a kill, and it's 23-20. But I see what you're saying. That advantage for UCLA right now with Lowe is on the near side pin closest to us. It's the sophomore Drolson to serve. Going short. Wanegu touched up by Lowe, but had a clean side for USC.
She was not really ready and in a defensive posture to make that play. Standing up too tall. Got to have your knees bent, balanced and forward.
Allie Pizza-Segola. A lot of young players on the floor on both sides. How do these times test them? Drolson, clutch pass. Robbins, the freshman, the set. And Lowe puts it away. And for the first time tonight, UCLA has set point. Now Carstolo off the floor, but they only need one. It's Stauber to set and serve. Big front line up there for UCLA. There's Lawless for the win, and UCLA is right back in it.
UCLA really upgraded its block, including that touch by Aquino there. Not all good blocks end up with as stuffs. They just create an easy play on your side of the net, and that leads to the UCLA kill.
And the Bruins take set three, 25-21. It's been a very tight match from the start to the finish, which is going to be a good one tonight. 2-1, USC on top. Sunset Plaza. Some beautiful spots here in Los Angeles, right along the Sunset Strip. 25-21, UCLA comes right back on this Los Angeles night of the Pac-12 opener. We take the third set. It was very tight. It's been a tight match from start to finish so far. Give me an update on what we talked about at the top with these offenses, what you're seeing through three sets.
UCLA is still having a lot of success slowing Bricio down.
Yeah.
And then they had some success. They commit block one time, stopped Olgaard just
right.
enough to slow that middle attack of USC, end up by a couple. Continue also to control that tough serve of Bricio. They do all that. They have a shot, of course, to win this match.
And you see our impact players for UCLA. Always impactful. They lean so heavily on Lowe and Reeves, and they've combined for 21 kills in this match. Reeves only has one error, but has taken 26 swings, so she's getting a lot of work in tonight. And through three sets, service errors have been a factor so far. They didn't kill UCLA, though, in that third. The UCLA block continues to perform well. They had four of their seven blocks in that third set. They really stepped it up in set number three at the net.
And they had a little more success at the service line. Got USC in a little bit of passing trouble. Went at Bricio a little bit. Then went back to Shaw to finish up. It'll be interesting to follow the UCLA serving strategy. And, of course, USC wants to continue to get those kills from Olgaard. Again, they'll have Bricio, their best server, and probably their top scoring rotation here at the line.
She's got an ace tonight. Sarah Shaw has two aces for USC. There's ace number two for Bricio to start set number four.
And this serve causes so many problems. It hasn't been going to our right much, but this time it tails right away toward that far sideline. Very difficult for Reeves to get two arms on it.
That time, good pass by Reeves. A push to the outside, and Lawless is done. Now it's sloppy out of the hands of Haley Krohn. The double hit is called.
Little surprise that got called. There have been some far worse than that. Earlier, she set the bar pretty low tonight in terms of clean contacts.
This is tie number 38 of the match. Lawless, diving dig by Haglin. That's her 17th dig of the match, and it turns into a Shaw kill.
Well, we saw a play that wasn't so smart by Sarah Shaw in the previous game. This one is a really smart shot. She catches low, backing out of the court,
yeah.
And there's space there. The setter doesn't want to take that. Lowe's got to take more of that. Nice vision by Sarah Shaw.
Nice serve by Haglin. Lawless, though, cutting it down the line just inside the antenna. That was a pretty kill by Lawless, who really made a nice impact as soon as she stepped on the floor for the third set.
She, too, finds the open space, and there was just a sliver between the antenna and blocker.
Stauber setting and serving. Shaw blocked back. Do they go to Olgaard here? They do. She's blocked. They're keying in on her. Aquino is staying up there and locking in on Olgaard. Lawless on the move with a big kill. 3-2 UCLA in front, and Lawless continues to impress in this match tonight.
And what a nice job by Aquino on the block in that play. Two soft blocks, but they slowed down the attack of USC.
And you pointed right away when Olgaard was in the middle, she was keeping a watchful eye on Alexis Olgaard. So that time a little late because she seems to be keying in on the middle when Abu is able to take advantage there. These are the little chess matches that are going on between Mick Haley and Michael Seeley.
And between setter and middle blocker, and trying to catch middles leaning one way or leaning the other.
Mick Haley has been coaching for 37 years at the collegiate level between community college and Division I. There for the transition of women's volleyball into a full-fledged NCAA sports. And he continues to be one of the ambassadors of this game. Former national team head coach. There's Olgaard. Again, it wasn't a stuff block. It's good enough to get UCLA in offensive possession. Now they go to Shaw. Olgaard's in front, and if UCLA is going to key, Shaw's going to have to be good the rest of the match.
And I was just going to say, if you're UCLA, you probably want a lot of sets going to Sarah Shaw. She
right.
is not the biggest terminator, and so when she puts that away, you just figure, well, that's fine. We want the ball to go there a lot. We'll get some other successes.
So now you see Shaw serving. That means Bricio's in front. And there is Olgaard for the seventh USC block of the night.
And the same thing, if UCLA wants Shaw to take a lot of swings, USC probably wants Reeves to take more and Karsta Lowe to take less. And that time, USC wins the matchup.
There's Reeves. Big hole in the block, and right there is Haglund to fill the seam. Tied at five. So we've been tied at every point through the first 10 here in the fourth. Mariana Aquino from Southern Brazil getting ready to serve. She said it's not typical Brazil. It's cold and it rains a lot in South Brazil, but a lot of places, a lot of space to play volleyball. There's Olgaard. Somebody was in the net. It's going to go against UCLA.
And the other thing Coach Seeley was saying is Aquino has really gotten a lot stronger. She stayed this past summer. Normally she would go home to Brazil. Stayed and got lots of lifting in and came back the strongest she's ever been, which often happens with seniors. They think, oh, this is my last year. All of a sudden it's kind of slipped away. I really want to take advantage of my last season with this team I play for.
Nightingale to tie us up at six. So again, both these teams transitioning to the 6-2, and each has a freshman setter. This is UCLA's freshman in Robbins. That's the USC freshman, Pizza Segola, sending it to Bricio for a lead-taking kill.
And it started with a pretty tough serve that I couldn't tell if it was going in or out. Sarah Shaw making a nice forearm angle on that, putting it right on the money. That's one of the terms in volleyball. You call it diming it, putting right on the dime and allowing your setter to run her offense.
And Pizza Segola off. That brings Haley Krohn on. UCLA in the net. I believe they got Reeves on that back pin. Nonetheless, first two-point lead in the fourth on either side. Oh, just off the tape and an ace for Krohn.
Ace!
That's one of those unlucky plays for the receiving team and lucky plays for the serving team to hit the tape, trickle over for the ace.
That was a deep service. Nightingale's blocked on two. It's low. There's Karsta Lowe with the kill.
Haglund a little upset with herself. She actually put herself in a great spot to make that play. did all the work. Most of the work as a defender is make the ball hit you, make the ball come to you. She did it on that play, but couldn't get it up in the air.
It's all about positioning.
Another nice pass by Shaw.
Jolson flexed that one up. It's a low set to Lawless. There's Carstolo on the backside. Shaw came up with a dig, leading to Wanebu. One linesman called it out, one called it in. And they're going to say it was out from Wanebu.
And you could see Mick Haley reading his lips. He's telling his setter, Haley Krohn, slow it down. Let's stay calm here. Let's give our hitters some time to make the play.
Bad pass, Bricio. We're tied up at nine. So three in a row for USC, three in a row for UCLA. Haley Krohn had to step into some big shoes. Kendall Bateman, the USC assist record holder. Haley stepped into her shoes last year. Now a junior. USC back on top.
That's a nice thing to have when you don't have a great pass. Just throw it up for somebody who's 6 foot six like that in Wanebu. Just go get it and attack the thing.
Low, blocked up front. Good read, but solo block by Hannah Schreer, and USC takes a two-point lead.
Yeah, Reeves controls this serve pretty well, but look at how low that set is and off the net. I don't think that's what Low was expecting, and she got blocked.
Again, Bricio serving, has a couple of aces tonight. Nicely handled by Reeves, but right into the block. Nightmare had Shaw and Schreer waiting for her, and Michael Seeley will use a timeout at 12-9. So UCLA's block was the dominant block in the third set. USC picking it up here in the fourth.
And USC anticipating that they'll not go back to Carstolo, so they get two blockers here. Up against the quick attack of UCLA. All of a sudden, the advantage swings to the two blockers up at the net.
USC getting a whole lot from a lot of different players tonight. You know, I was just looking through numbers and stats and things like that before the match, and a note that stuck out for USC offensively. Only two players this year have strung together back-to-back double-digit kill matches. And they were the freshmen. They were Ruddins and Wanebu. Bricio, if she hits 10 tonight, she will have accomplished that as well. She'll only be the third player all year for USC to have back-to-back double-digit kill matches. And, you know, we kind of asked the staff, so what is that about? Why does that, you know, how does that play out? It goes, a lot of teams you would think, oh, they're just not hitting that well. USC's hitting pretty well as a team. It's just the balance that they have. And you said it, UCLA's kind of messing with its lineup just to try to figure out who they can fill in. USC's trying to mix in players because they've got so much talent and so much depth.
And that's something that's wise to do, to play lots of players, especially early in the season before conference play starts, because injuries always crop up. And when you have those injuries, it's great that the players behind that starter have earned the right to be confident and come in, and the team can be confident in that player, in that substitute coming in.
Alicia Ogums, a middle blocker, big part of last year's USC team, dealing with a concussion. So Schreer has stepped in and really handled the M2 position this year. Lawless blocked back by Wanebu. They go back to her. Oh, what a great dig by Bricio. Here's Shaw on the outside, and Robbins, the setter, Doug Hurd. You got USC in the net, so UCLA ends up getting the point. A good effort, though, by Bricio on the back line. That was a one-handed dig.
Laying out far to her right. See the space, and then all of a sudden she steps in there. It was a good shot, but a better defensive play.
Well, we've seen plays like that on both sides all night. There's one able. Have you seen that tonight from the pin right inside to the middle on a little slide?
Yeah, a few times they've wanted to run her and have run her in front of the setter. And then they keep Schreyer running behind the setter, so it's a double quick attack. Tough to figure out how to block on that.
Haley, you're digging here. Come on.
Jolson the pass. Nice tempo. Aquino is dug. Krohn's out of the play. One able. Oh, man. Just tough. Tough for anybody to block that with her size and how high she gets.
Especially when the set gets left inside, but the UCLA block goes too far outside. So all of a sudden, they're standing out by the sideline, and it's an easy cross-court kill.
Right back at Drolson. This time Karsten Lowe tried to cut it to the near side. But all of a sudden, USC is starting to pull away. And Michael Seely is going to use his second timeout in the first 25 points of this fourth set. And the Trojans are 10 away from a 3-1 win. So we were tied at 9. It's a 6-1 USC run, their largest lead of this match at 5.
And it looks like Bricio is trying to figure out some of her defensive positioning. Do I play farther to the right? Remember, she had to lay it out with her right hand. So she's asking Coach Haley, where would you like me to play on those on the specific hitter that UCLA, which happens to be Haley Lawless.
Lawless, redshirt freshman. Claire Felix was in for the first two sets for UCLA. She is a freshman. Jordan Robbins is setting. She's a freshman. Wanebu, Pizza Segola, Ruddins. They've all made impacts. Lawless, a redshirt. Everybody else a true freshman. They've all been involved in this match in some way tonight in a positive way on both sides. Well, these teams have a nice mix of veteran leadership and a lot of young talent. And one of those freshmen is Ebony Wanebu, and she's been really impressive tonight.
Sure has a tall player, strong, jumps well, and it is nice when you have a player like that that you can just throw it up to, not somebody so much like Sarah Shaw on one side of the net or Kelly Reeves on the other, but just big who can terminate the ball even against very strong blockers for various opponents that they'll face.
She's got 15 kills to lead USC. Karsten Lowe has 15 to lead UCLA. Bruin still hitting over 300. USC is now at 289. There's Lawless, and Wanebu comes up with a block. Right on cue, it's a 6-point Trojan lead.
And UCLA is trying to run it faster. You saw that set was lower to try to beat the block of USC, but she hit it right into the end blocker.
Defense. Haglund saved it. Here's Wanebu off the net.
Again, pretty nice to have somebody like that to throw the ball up to. Now UCLA looking to make a change here. If you're out of timeouts, sometimes you'll make a substitution just to try to slow things down, and they are in a pretty big bleed here, giving up lots of points in a row.
And they bring in Frager, a freshman, try to slow down this USC front line with Olgaard and Wanebu up there. Bailey Krohn's out of the play. Shaw coming inside. Lawless on the outside. Out of bounds, and USC has an 8-point lead.
And here comes another sub in. Yep. Trying to slow down the serving run of Natalie Haglund at the service line for USC.
That's Maddie Smith coming in. Adam Amin, U.S. Women's National Team head coach Karch Kiraly, and the Pac-12 opener tonight between a pair of one-loss teams on the season through preseason play, USC and UCLA. Trojans got the first two sets of this match here at the Galen Center in L.A. UCLA came back for a win in the third. USC and UCLA tied at 9 in the fourth. It's been a USC run of 9-2. The Galen Center has been a house of horrors for anybody that has stepped into it. 96-10 are the Trojans all time here at the Galen Center. UCLA, which is banged up, which is transitioning to the 6-2, as is USC, but a banged up UCLA team is getting a real test here tonight. This is going to be a huge night for them. When they go back and watch this film, if they do end up falling behind and losing this match, it's going to be a night that they look back on, and a lot of growth happened for a lot of these younger players. Shaw off the antenna. UCLA gets another point. They've strung together a couple. They're within a half dozen. Too easy for Haglin. One able all alone. That's her seventh kill in this set alone.
That was not a tough serve, but a strategic serve, trying to clog the offensive lanes of USC. It didn't work that time. And you don't want to leave somebody who's got seven kills in one game, in one set, alone, one-on-one blocking.
18 on the night for Wanabu. Nice serve by Pizza Segola. Nice job just getting it up by Drolson. Lawless into the antenna. USC hits 20. They're 5 points away. Pizza Segola came to the United States in August. It was the first time she'd ever been to the U.S. when she joined the USC team. Nice kill by Felix, who's come back into the match. Another one of the freshmen we talked about. This is what we see in the Pac-12 once you hit conference play. Week in, week out, these types of matches. Termination.
And literally, you could hear her again. 1-1-1. She yelled it three times, trying to talk the setter into going to her. Another kill.
Bricio. So a few hitting errors here by USC. We saw this a little bit last week against a non-conference opponent in UC Irvine. At the end of sets, a little bit of trouble by USC to close out opponents. Young. A lot of heat on that ball until it was the block. 3 points away.
Yeah, you think with Wanabu out of the game, you're going to get a break, and then
right.
Young just rips one off the block and out of bounds.
There's one of the stars of tonight's match, the senior out of Spokane, Alexis Olgaard. Down official checking something at the scorer's table. I didn't see anybody maybe ask for a rotation check, but this is what Olgaard has done tonight. 13 kills. Second on the team for USC tonight behind Wanabu's near 20. Might be checking on how many subs he's got left too, because Michael Seeley was bringing somebody in. So again, Aquino had to run back on. It's the libero substitution. They wanted to make sure that was correct. So now the lineup sorted out for UCLA. And Olgaard.
And got one last pseudo timeout out
that's
of there.
Right, yeah, little, that's a little gamesmanship there.
Yep, a little break. You never give up hope. It doesn't look great, but lots of comebacks have been mounted from worse deficits than this.
That's the point in her game that she wanted to improve. It was her blocking coming into this year after such an outstanding offensive year last year. Wanted to be a better blocker. We're seeing flashes of it in the first 12 matches of the season for USC. Ten match points for USC. Keeps the points alive. Marissa Lowe back in the match for the Bruins. She's led the way for UCLA tonight. Maddie Smith on serve. Appreciate it. It is stopped. Nightingale and Lowe. I'd be curious if McKaylee uses a timeout at any point. He steps out, says relax. Still match point. Between crosstown foes and USC comes away with a 3-1 win.
Well, USC's size and strength and physical play at the net was really the difference. And Wanebu, a great indicator of that with 7 kills in that last game alone.
USC gets its 11th win of the season. They're 11-1. UCLA drops to 9-2. Outstanding match tonight, and they'll do it again on November the 27th, 13 miles away at Pauley Pavilion. But USC in the Pac-12 opener gets the victory over its longtime crosstown rivals. Coming up next, college football. You'll see the re-air of Michigan and UConn. For Karch Kiraly and our outstanding crew out here on the West Coast, Adam Amin saying good night from the Gaylord Center.